Hey everybody, it's Jack with Future Past Times, and it's time for the Cosmic Encounter Alien of the Month for September 2024. This is an alien from Cosmic Eons. It's a pretty powerful alien with some crazy impact on the game and an unusual effect going on with its alien sheet, and that alien is Multitude. Now you can see that Multitude has these little spaces around here with multipliers on them, and it's the perfect size for a cosmic token, which you will need to use to track this effect, which we will get into. So let's take a look at what Multitude does, and then we'll talk about why it's such a crazy power. You have the power of exponentiation. There's a mouthful. Whenever there are no cosmic tokens on this sheet, place one on the times one exponential growth factor. Now, this was a way for us to not have game setup text on this alien. So pretty much the only time there's going to be no cosmic token on this sheet is when you first set up. But this means that you can bring Multitude into a game in progress with some effect where you're adding aliens. So let's get into what it actually does. Whenever your color or any special destiny card is drawn from the destiny deck, use this power to double your exponential growth factor by moving the token from times one to times two or from times two to times four. So as you can see, it doubles. One doubled is two, doubled is four, doubled is eight, 16, and up to 32. Now, whenever a wild destiny card is drawn from the destiny deck, use this power to reset your exponential growth factor to times one. So there are two wild destiny cards in your destiny deck, irrespective of the number of players. And we'll talk more about that here in just a moment. But what does Multitude actually do? Well, it's here in our last paragraph. As a main player or ally, the value of each of your ships participating in the encounter is multiplied by your exponential growth factor when counting toward your side's total in an encounter. So when you start off, it's times one. Each ship is worth one, which is pretty normal. But pretty quickly, it's going to start moving up. And imagine where each of your ships is worth 32. That's bananas. Now, I've played with Multitude several times, and I have seen it get up to 32 once, although while it was at 32, it didn't actually get used in an encounter. And the very next encounter was a wild, so it got reset, but it did get used. I've seen it used at 16, so where each of your ships is worth 16 is already a pretty big deal. So in a game with a low player count, you're going to see those wilds more often and more frequently. There's more of a chance that you will get through the whole destiny deck and you will be, having to reset again. But in a game with a large player count, you could go many, many, many encounters before you get to a wild, or you might get the wilds out very early, and then you have a much higher chance of getting to get up to the 32. So in terms of scaling, it doesn't scale as much as it should. Now, I advocated for having it be reset by, hazard warning, and that would scale with the number of players. And then, the wilds would be another opportunity to advance it. So if you're like, oh, I drew, this is purple and you've drawn greens, hazard warning, boom, you get reset. But now with, a wild special destiny or purple, it's, boom, 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 moving up. And you're more likely to be in this range where you got the four and the eight for most of the game. But I got overruled. So I'm thinking about making an amendment to this for my TTS version of Multitude. So let me know in the comments if you think we should, if I should go for it, or if you prefer it this way. I do like this alien. It's a fun alien. This was one of Bill and Peter's aliens from Cosmic Eons, where they wanted to have something that was as scary, if not scarier, than Virus, which for many decades was the go-to for, this is a scary, powerful alien, how can you possibly ever beat it? And it's also a multiplying alien. So here it's a little bit different in terms of what it does, and your ship resources become elevated, and they're much more important during the game. You want to be able, when you're at, you know, times 8 or 16 or 32, you want to be able to bring four ships into an encounter. So there's a lot more at risk for ship-wise, but God, if you're bringing in four ships and each one's worth 32, you're probably going to win that encounter. Chances are you'll win it. So, you know, the rich get richer with this sort of thing, and you want to take advantage of it because you're not going to be at 32 for very long. Before long, boop, you're going to be back to one, which is where everyone else is. So you're not at a real disadvantage, but you're waiting for the right destiny cards to help pump you up better. So I like this. I like this alien. I think it's really interesting and innovative. It was one that Fantasy Flight was not sure how they wanted to implement this, but this was kind of how we did it in our playtesting, and they just relented and said, "All right, fine, we'll do it." It's a different alien sheet template, which they don't like necessarily, at least not then, to participate in. But I like the fact that we've got a couple of original sheets. You've got the throwback, and then you've got the alt timeline ones, the regular ones, and then these. So it's kind of fun. I'm going to try to put together a game where we're all just using weird alien sheets. I'd love for there to be a couple more that break the mold. You do have the, you know, where the frame is slightly bigger. The ones that have more text use the extended text frame, which shrinks down your image. So that would technically count as a different format. Anyway, that's it for this Alien of the Month. Let me know your thoughts on Multitude. Do you like this alien? Do you absolutely hate it? It is divisive. There's some people who just think it's absurd. It's too much like Virus. I think it's definitely different enough from Virus. I like what it does. And I like that there's another multiplying alien, and it does it in a different and interesting way. But absolutely share your thoughts and share any interesting stories that you have where Multitude was in action, whether you were playing it or playing against it. And how did you do and how did it do? Let us know in the comments. That's it for this one. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you again soon.